Hey, GrowGroup family, really, really glad that you're still digging through the story of Jesus and exploring more of the book of John. Here is a snippet from this week's message.
Now, next, Jesus prays. This is verse 18. He says, "As you sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world." Right? This is the second thing he wants us to do. He wants us to go on mission. Jesus says, just like I came into the world to change it, so I want my followers to do the same. Jesus says in verse 15, "My prayer is not that you take them out of the world, but that you would protect them from the evil one." See, Jesus, he's not trying to insulate or isolate you from the hard problems of our world. And when he says world, he's not referring to like the globe or the planet. What Jesus means by the world is the agreed upon system of selfishness that we're all a part of. Jesus is not asking that God remove us from this agreed upon system of selfishness, from this selfish world. No, Jesus is praying that you and I would be agents of change in a selfish world. Let me illustrate. Have you ever been back to your elementary school, as a teen or as an adult? I was an Air Force brat, so I changed schools often, and I remember going to a new school and feeling intimidated because like everything was so big and scary. But when I went back to that classroom, as an adult, I had a completely different view. The school was small. The water fountain I used to have to rise up on my tippy toes to use was like at shin height. The toilets that I feared would like swallow me up, they were amusingly small. And the desk, like I was like this guy. See this picture? This desk, it's so tiny. It's like up at his knee height. My point is this, you and I, we grow. But to grow, we have to go. We have to go through first grade, through second grade, through third grade, and so on. There's an educational journey, a physical journey, an emotional journey. And Jesus says here that there is a spiritual journey. And to grow, you have to go. You say, where do I go? Well, God doesn't tell you. He just says, start going. You think about all the Bible people. Abraham, I want you to go. Where, God? I'm not telling you, Abraham. Just start going. Joseph, go through a bunch of trials in Egypt. Moses, go to Pharaoh, confront him. Esther, go to the dangerous king, save the people. Jonah, go to the people you hate in Nineveh. Joshua, go take back the land from the enemies. Every single minor prophet, go, go, go. Jesus to the 12, go make disciples. Jesus to us, go. Listen, the growing is in the going. You cannot have a full, abundant life until you follow your Creator and go. Don't expect a great life to come to you. It won't ever. It's not coming. You gotta go. If you won't ever get off your duff and go somewhere for God, don't expect to grow in the recliner to have a great life. Now, how far do you need to go? Well, I don't know. For some of you, you might have to go like 8,000 miles to Kenya, like my friend Jonathan does regularly. Others of you might have to go like 18 steps over to your children's ministry building and volunteer. Some of you, God wants you to take 30 steps to your neighbor's house, knock on the door and say, "Hey, I'm watching The Pointe next week on my computer, on my TV. Want to come watch with me?" And I guarantee you that what you thought was big and scary, well, if you go, it'll become small and wonderful because we're changed by the going, by the journey. The growing is in the going. Facebook, YouTube, put an amen in the feed if you hear me now.
Ooh, I love that illustration about going back to school. I was just at a back to school night with my kiddos, and those desks are so tiny and so cute. And so in just a few minutes, your leader will guide you through a list of questions, but let's start with this one. If you could go back to one of those schools you attended, which one would you go back to? And why?